So open up the Showtime show. You got Xavier Martinez versus Juan Carlos Burgos. Now, I don't know if you guys remember Burgos. He fought Mikey Garcia back in the day. Gave him a decent fight. Devin Haney fought him. He fought Hector Tanahata. And he's a pretty good, you know, he's a pretty good trial horse right now. He always, you know, when he step up in competition, he normally loses. This is first time fighting at 130. This is a WBA eliminator. This is Burgos' first time fighting it at 130 or below in probably like 5 years. So we're going to see. He said, heck yes, I want to see Nery versus Brandon. Yeah, that's going to be fireworks. Yes, sir. Fireworks. So, you know, Burgos is a tall guy. He got a good jab. You know what I'm saying? He really, I mean, at this stage of his career, he's more so of a, they're about to turn him into a journeyman type of opponent. But he's tough. He should give Martinez rounds. Now, Martinez, he's a TMT fighter. He got a high rank in the WBA at 130. I think he's number two behind Christopher Colbert. He's a good puncher, solid. Didn't look so great. He said he looked like Triple G. Martinez didn't look so great in his last fight. He fought a tough veteran, Claudio Marrero, who had him hurt and dropped twice. But I like the way he got up and rallied, though. So it's not really like, it's not really a bad thing to get dropped, you know what I'm saying, per se, if you don't know, because you can rebound from that and you can come stronger like he did. He got back in that fight. I thought he was up out of there, but he got back in that fight and won basically the rest of the rounds. So salute to him for that, and that's a learning experience. But Martinez is a good puncher, though. He's a good puncher. I haven't seen Burgos get up. I don't think Burgos ever been stopped, so that'd be a nice little feather in the cap. Mikey beat him. Devin Haney all boxed him. You can say Devin Haney probably beat him the best because he all boxed him for 10 rounds. So we'll see, man. And you can tell just by the matchup what Mayweather Promotions think of Martinez. Because they was going to throw him in there with Christopher Colbert. But after that last performance, you see how they stepping him down a little bit. You know what I'm saying? Because the last fight he won was an eliminator. And this is another eliminator. So he might see Chris Colbert down the line. But, you know what I'm saying, these guys now on the same schedule. He fighting in May. Chris Colbert fighting in July. And if you guys follow my template, how I be figuring out these matchups, that's one of them. They got to be on the same schedule, at least 3 weeks apart. They damn near a month and some change. You know what I'm saying? So I don't see TMT pushing him towards Colbert, but this should be a pretty good fight, though. You know what I'm saying? Martinez guy, I know that the last fight he kind of took a step back because of the knockdowns, but he's a strong kid, solid, durable, good puncher, and he got some dog in him, so we'll see. And he's trained by Diego Corrales' stepdad. We all remember that fight with when he fought Mayweather and he stopped the fight. And the same guy, I think his name, I forgot, I know his name, Ray. But